Gandhian thought or philosophy has been understood and explained by scholars and subject specialists from time to time all over the world as per their own interpretation of his ideology. The story continues till date. Mahatma Gandhi, with a single objective, struggled throughout his life at many fronts to achieve his objective. And as we know, his ideas or philosophy developed from those very years of struggle, experimenting and implementing his ideas. Accepting one or more than one of his approaches as the most important from his work, from the large-scale welfare of the people viewpoint. Scholars explain Gandhi Vichar or philosophy of Mahatma Gandhi accordingly to say having the same work or experiment of Mahatma in the center. At the core of Mahatma Gandhi's entire idea is the reality of indivisible whole, Avibhajya Samagrata. Gandhi Darshan is dedicated to the truth of universal unity, Sarvabhaumik Ekta. Gandhiji's philosophy moves forward by connecting all spheres of life, socio-cultural, political, intellectual, religious, spiritual, and economic as one, due to their inevitable interdependence. Due to this, Gandhian thought, which seems to be very simple, has its own special place in all the philosophies developed around the world from time to time. This truth is well revealed when one goes into the depth of views expressed of Mahatma Gandhi on almost all subjects related to all walks of life, periodically and course of action set by him. It clearly appears that Mahatma Gandhi firmly believed in the reality of complete perfection and unity of all, and he worked throughout his life having this truth as the nucleus, as his operational strategy. It was the result of acceptance of this reality by the Mahatma that he worked in all walks of life and continuously struggled for human equality, making it in all walks of life and continuously struggle for human equality, making it the prime objective of his life. I have indicated this in the beginning of my talk. Equality is of paramount importance in the truth-based eternal principle of indivisible whole and universal unity. It is the nucleus of this undying reality. Gandhiji well realized this in South Africa, where he discovered an unprecedented weapon of satyagraha, purely based on ahimsa, non-violence. That is why equality remained at the center of all of his work. Struggle in South Africa, followed by India. This state is quite clear from a short statement made by Mahatma Gandhi himself in Young India on March 12, 1925. He said, "My central aim is equal treatment for whole of humanity, and that equal treatment means equality of service. Equality is the natural right of everyone from the Lord, our Creator. It is the most valuable ornament of human life. Three other important aspects related to human life, freedom, justice, and right, are indivisibly connected with equality. Since ancient times, great men, men of the era, leading figures from the field of religion or the dharma kshetra, which leave deep impact on human life, always kept human equality highest in their messages. They expected man to treat each other equally. In the scriptures also, the aspect of human equality emerged in the most prominent form. However, the establishment of equality is perhaps the most difficult task. Even after accepting the reality of human equality in principle, true action on the same is quite difficult. There are some particular reasons behind this state. However, we will leave those details for a later going discussion. But still I want to say that the sense of inequality and unequal conduct of man with fellow beings are the cause of all difficulties, problems and conflicts at all levels in all spheres of life. A great humanist, Mahatma Gandhi, knew and understood this reality well. He accepted the state of the interdependence of all spheres of life, the reality of indivisibility, and kept human equality directly or indirectly in the center of all his thoughts. For that, he strived with devotion throughout his life. In the entire philosophy of Mahatma Gandhi, decentralization of power, trusteeship in the economic sphere, upliftment of our rural sector, women's empowerment and other constructive activities, four-point education plan, Antyodaya to Sarvodaya Yojana, establishment of an ideal democracy, the Ram Rajya, the spirit of human equality remained the most valuable and desirable. Similarly, the foremost purpose of all of his non-violent struggles, satyagrahas for freedom, justice and right, was to bring everyone within the domain of equality. It was to pave the way for self-reliance of everyone by providing equal opportunities to one and all. The true familiarity with Gandhian thought, therefore, as I believe, can only be possible by keeping his equality-related ideas in the center. Thank you very much.